Live from Salt Lake City, Utah, this is Fox 13 News.
Thanks. All right, the kids from Mountain Crest High, that's in Hiram, and the Monticello 4-H Club and the Design Academy at Utah State, they are headed to the national championships, Dan, and it's all because of their
robots.
Robots.
They build robots.
Smart kids.
Yeah, it's all for the VEX Robotics World Championship, where the students go head-to-head in international competition. This is a big deal. Joining us this morning from Orlando are VEX Robotics President Paul Copioli and Kyle Womack from Mountain Crest High, who's taking part in this year's competition.
Go Kyle!
Yeah, good to see you both. Kyle, congratulations to you, buddy.
Thank you very much.
So first of all, Kyle, tell us a little bit about how you got there. What did you build?
I just took an engineering class and just built this robot and put it together, and that's how I got here.
Well, what is it? What does it do?
It picks up these blue rings right here and scores them on the goalpost.
Okay, well, I'm just thinking my kids, you know, play with Legos and stuff. I don't know that they would have ever dreamed of something like that. How did you come up with this idea and all the wiring and making it work and move?
We start off with the basic forklift, like in a store or whatever, and we just started putting it together from there.
It looks like an Erector set, kind of, you know, back in the day, remember those things? So Paul, tell us why building robots like these, I mean, I can pick up the rings, I don't want to bend over and pick them up off the floor, but why building robots like this, why is this so important right now? What's the point?
Well, it's all about engagement, right? So you mentioned Legos and you mentioned the younger kids, right? It's really easy to get elementary school kids interested in science and technology. They just think it's cool, right? You know, space, robots, and dinosaurs. Mm-hmm. They're it's all very cool. Once they get into middle school and high school, we start to lose them. So the whole point of the VEX Robotics competition is to keep kids interested in things technological, right? So we design a game that they play every year. They design and build their robots to play the game. They're having fun, they're interacting with other students, you know, learning communication skills, but at the same time that they're having fun, they're learning. We call it tricking them into learning, right? So by the end of this whole thing, they actually know a bunch of stuff about science and technology, and they actually realize that this stuff is cool and they can do it themselves. But what it also does is it helps prepare them for if they do want to pursue a technological career, they will have the basic building blocks and tool sets to get into university and become successful scientists and engineers.
So Kyle, was it fun? Was this process fun? And did you have a couple of, you know, robots that didn't work and then you had to go back to the drawing board? I mean, what was that process like for you?
We've redesigned this robot a lot. We just started out with like the basic forks and we had to add on and take off and just rebuild it. And
yeah, but did you ever get really, you know, like, oh, this doesn't work, throw the pieces against the floor, start over?
Exactly.
You seem too calm for that.
I don't know if he's the kind of guy to throw stuff against the wall. See, that's probably why I don't build robots. Yeah, this is pretty cool stuff. So Paul, though, tell us what kinds of things come out of this competition. Aside from duping these guys into learning, what kinds of things come out of it?
So basically, right, this is the VEX Robotics competition is the largest competition, high school and middle school, in the world. All these guys are down here. There's 10,000 participants at the VEX Robotics World Championship here in Orlando. Every one of these teams won one of their tournaments or received a qualifying award to be down here. So this is a very competitive tournament. What these students get exposed to here, a lot of our corporate partners and sponsors are here. They are here, you know, they're supporting us, supporting the students, but they're really here to recruit and to find the future engineers and scientists that they can, you know, take out of university and you know, have them build the new technological products of the future.
We are looking at the future then right now. All right, and what does the winner get from this whole competition? Quickly before we let you go.
Well, yeah, sure. Again, everybody, they all get exposed to these great companies, right? Sorry, it's starting to get loud here. They get exposed to these great winners of each of the divisions. They receive a pretty cool trophy. They get the sweet banner. They also get automatic qualification to come back here next year, so they don't actually have to requalify. They have the chance to defend their title. So those are the things that they physically get out of this competition.
Very cool.
Plus they learn. They're tricked into learning out there. And you can take that to the bank. All right.
That's
Paul
right.
And Kyle, thanks a lot for joining us this morning, and good luck to you, Kyle.
You're welcome.
Thanks for having us.
Time right now is 7:20. If you're looking for a good laugh or a history